All right. You may be seated. Thank you. Let the record show today's date is March the 7th, 2024. We are in the Pike County Court of Common Pleas, General Division. We're here on a criminal case, State of Ohio versus George Washington Wagner III, case number 2018 CR000157. This is Judge R. Allen Corbin acting by assignment from the Supreme Court. We are here this afternoon upon a request by the defense to continue the jury trial, which we currently have scheduled for May the 6th of this year. It was scheduled to commence on that date. However, there are several issues that were raised during a phone conference that we had in this matter, including some medical issues, some other issues, just a variety of issues that the defense has indicated may necessitate a continuance of this trial. And I know for everyone, and I know especially for the Roden family, I know that that's not something you probably wanted to hear, nor did I, actually. However, I've been a trial lawyer for many years and then a judge for many, many years, and I know sometimes we have to do these kinds of things. So I'm going to let the defense state the reasons that they believe this should be continued. We do have present Angel R. Canepa as Special Prosecutor on behalf of the State of Ohio. Also, Special Agent Scheiderer from DCI is here. On behalf of the defendant, we have Mark C. Collins and Thomas F. Hayes. And the defendant, George Washington Wagner III, is present as well. So at this time, I will defer to you, counsel, for Mr. Wagner, and you may state your reasons for requesting this continuance, and then I'll hear from Ms. Canetta.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. May it please the court, on behalf of Billy, Mr. Hayes, and I appreciate the professionalism of having this hearing today and the phone conference that we had initially. And for the record, Your Honor, Mr. Hayes and I have both, as well as Ms. Canepa, have tried death penalty cases and been involved in it.
Well, if you wish to be seated, you may do so.
That's okay.
All right. If anybody, Mr. Wagner, if you wish to be seated, anybody? Okay.
I appreciate your courtesy, Your Honor. We've tried these types of cases, Your Honor, and in starting to get ready for this case, some things came up, and Mr. Hayes and I had conversations as well with our client. First and foremost, Your Honor, Mr. Hayes had a knee replacement. It took a lot longer for him to come back to work than he believed that it was going to happen. Subsequently, Your Honor, we received about 16,000 pages of transcripts, Your Honor, in January. Trying to go through those, and that's a big task, Your Honor, and something that we will complete at some point. What we didn't want to have happen, Your Honor, is get close to the May date and realize, hey, we couldn't be ready. Part of the aspect is, Your Honor, one of our co-counsel, Ms. Emily Anstadt, just had a baby. She is not set to come back until early May, Your Honor. And because of the delay with regards to Mr. Hayes's rehabilitation and going back full-time to work with his knee, and Ms. Anstep being out, our client has made it very clear to us that he did not want to go forward without Ms. Anstep being here and being properly prepared. In addition, Your Honor, I had a death penalty case scheduled for April in front of Judge Roberts in Delaware. And so based on that, Your Honor, out of abundance of caution, we believe that we should definitely get to this court and get to the prosecutor in advance. And I apologize, Your Honor, to the Roden family, Your Honor, that we're requesting this, but it's something that we didn't want to have happen a day or two or a week before the trial, Your Honor. So we looked at everything realistically, and we just can't be ready for that May 6th date. Multiple reasons in addition to the ones I've stated, Your Honor, but in terms of the respect for the court and the process and for the Roden family, we wanted to be upfront and transparent with regards to that. We do believe, Your Honor, in addition, based on our trial schedules of definite trials that are set, that we do believe we have a time that we can try this, and we understand that if the court were to grant us this request of ours to continue the case, and I'm sure the government will object, as they should, that we understand that if we're given a new date, that that date would be a rock-solid date. That date would be one that would not be able to be moved. Your Honor, if the court were to grant this, we would waive time as per the speedy trial rights. We've always had a waiver, Your Honor, but we would formally on the record waive time for that. In addition, Your Honor, we've had conversations with the prosecution that because of a new potential trial date, it may inconvenience or it may bring up some minor issues with the prosecution's witnesses. We understand that we would have to accommodate them with a video testimony or potential with their transcript from before. We understand that. We understand that that's a reality if the court were to grant us continuous. This is kind of, Your Honor, the first time that it's actually been set, so to speak, in trial language talk, that the May date was one that we were all working towards. And so this is kind of the first continuance request for an actual trial date. And we understand that whatever occurs, if the court were to grant the continuance, we would be not allowed to ask for another continuance, Your Honor.
All right. But thank you, Mr. Collins. Mr. Hayes?
Nothing.
All right. Thank you. Yes. You may be seated. Ms. Canepa.
Thank you, Your Honor. Your Honor, obviously, Mr. Collins touched on a lot of this, that as you did as well, that I don't worry about myself when with this kind of continuous request, but the victim's family in this case, you know, has been dealing with this and wanting justice and closure since, you know, April of 2016, basically, when they first learned of this tragedy. So, you know, the case was indicted in 2018, and while I do, you know, completely understand that, you know, the defendant here in court, along with their attorneys, or his attorneys, were not really, quote, on the bubble, so to speak, until, you know, more recently, I would say after George's trial ended at the end of 2022. We certainly do object to a continuance at this time, Your Honor, and I understand, you know, the court's already indicated that having been an advocate yourself and also a judge, you know, what goes into your decision. I did express to the court, to counsel, and I will express here on the record as well, that if the court does grant this continuance, we do request that whatever new date it is, that all parties protect it on the calendar, and that, you know, a continuance not be granted again, barring some extraordinary circumstances, obviously. And, you know, again, Mr. Collins touched on this as well, that any challenges that this creates to the state with any of its witnesses, who, for the record, are all available and ready, you know, for a May trial date, you know, that whatever accommodations can be given from the defense would be granted. So, that's all, Your Honor.
All right. Thank you. Anything else, counsel?
No, Your Honor.
Well, I do believe that there are good reasons for giving consideration to the defense request for a continuance. I know we have discussed those on the record somewhat here today through Mr. Collins. And I understand I will be receiving the 16,000 pages today and I'm going to need to review those as well. And I do know that Ms. Anstett, who's one of the co-counsel, is currently unavailable and won't be back until sometime, I think, in May of this year. And I know Mr. Hayes has had some issues that have kept him away from work, and hopefully you're coming back from that, Mr. Hayes. And then Mr. Collins, with the death penalty trial and then several other trials, he set some pretty big trials that were already scheduled. Reluctantly, I'm going to have to grant the request for continuance. And I say reluctantly, not that I don't think it's justified. I wouldn't be granting it if I didn't think it was. However, I do know that the Roden family, I have to call them alleged victims at this point, family, you know, it probably isn't too enthused about this, and I understand that, and I apologize. But I think in order to afford reasonable accommodations to the defense to present their case and to prepare to present it, this continuance is necessary. So I am granting a continuance of the May 6th trial date. And unfortunately, we discussed in chambers possible dates, and the earliest date that we can get everyone, for including the court and the defense and I think the state, but I know the state has some witness issues, is going to be January the 6th of 2025. And I know, Mr. Collins, you've indicated you understand that will be a firm date and we will plan to go forward at that time.
That's correct, John.
That's the earliest that we could come up with. I was hopeful we could find something sooner than that, but with everything that we have to deal with, January 6, 2025, so I am ordering that the jury trial in this case, Mr. Wagner's jury trial, is hereby continued until January the 6th, 2025. We have checked with the court personnel, and they are keeping the period of time open that we feel we would need to complete this trial, to select the jury, complete the trial, and that is the order of the court. The continuance request is granted, continued until January 6th of 25. I will note your exception, Ms. Canepa, on behalf of the Roden family. And again, I'm not real happy with having to do this, but I do understand the necessity from the defense perspective to continue this matter. So it is granted. Is there anything else here this afternoon, Mr. Collins or Mr. Hayes?
I think, Your Honor, the only thing is we're going to stay in contact with Ms. Canepa to work on aspects as well as the court personnel to make sure that everything will flow smoothly for the January 6th time period.
All right. And I know there was discussion about getting together and working out some of the procedural issues that need to be taken care of between now and the trial date, and I did state that I will make myself available for a conference with counsel at any time that you need any input from me. So let's keep it moving, and
absolutely,
we're planning to do it on January 6th and go forward and complete it.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Anything else, counsel?
No, Your Honor.
Ms. Canepa?
No, and Mr. Collins did put this on the record, but just that speedy trial is waived for
absolutely
the period of discontinuance.
Yes. Do you understand that, Mr. Wagner?
Yeah.
All right. He indicated yes, affirmative. All right. If there's nothing else, we'll stand in recess. I thank everyone for being here this afternoon. We are in recess.
Thank you. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Thank you.